Hi everyone. In today's session, let us discuss or let us solve the problem of finding optimal transportation cost when there is a situation of degeneracy. So what is degeneracy, and in the case of degeneracy, how to solve the problem? We will discuss while solving the problem. So here let us see the today's problem. Find the optimal solution of the following transportation problem. So this is the problem given to us. So now we need to find the optimal cost. Optimal cost means the optimality test need to be conducted, right? So first of all, let us check whether it is a balanced or unbalanced problem. So now I am going to check that one. So calculate the total capacity, 30 plus 25 plus 35 plus 40. It is 130. Next, calculate the total demand, 40 plus 50 plus 40. It is also 130. So total capacity is equals to total demand, so that the problem is balanced. Now let us find the initial transportation cost for the given problem by VAM method, that is Vogel's approximation method, as it is the best method in order to find that. So now I am going to find that one. So first of all, I am going to find the first iteration of row and column penalties. So first, the two minimum values are 8 and 11. So difference is 3. And here, the first two minimal values are 12, 16. Difference is 4. Here, 7, 10. Difference is 3. Here, 8 and 9. Difference is 1. And next, column penalties. 10 and 12 are the first two minimal values, difference is 2. Here 7 and 8, difference is 1. Here 8 and 9, difference is 1. So here I am going to solve this by VAM method. I already know. If anybody is not aware of the VAM method, already I made a video how to solve the problem by VAM method. Please watch that video. I am leaving that video in the cards. So now select the maximum penalty value, 4, and in this row, what is the least cost? 12. So assign a number of units of 25, then it will be 0, and here it will be 15. And next, as it is 0, strike off this row. Next, find the second iteration of penalties. So here it will be 3, hyphen, as second row is not there, this will be also 3, 1. And next, here minimum values are 10, 12, so difference 2, minimal values are 7, 8, difference 1, minimal values are 8 and 9, difference is 1. So the maximum penalties is 3, but the 3 is different, placed at two different places. If you take this 3, in this row minimum cost is 8. If you take this 3, in this row minimum cost is 7, but we need to assign to minimum cost. So in 8 and 7, minimum is 7. So I am going to take this row, and to this cell I am allotting the units. How many units I am assigning means 35 units. So here it will become 0, and here it will become 15. As this becomes 0, so strike off that row. Next, calculate the third iteration of penalties. So here 3, hyphen, third row is also cancelled, and here it is 1. And next, here the two values are 12, 21, so difference is 9, and here the difference between 8 and 11 is 3, difference between 8 and 9 is 1. So the maximum penalty is 9, So in this column, what is the minimal value? 12. So I am going to assign these units to this cell. 40. So this becomes 0 and this one also becomes 0. So row became 0. So strike off that one. Column also became 0. So strike off that one. Next, calculate the fourth iteration of penalties. Difference is 3. Second row cancel, third row cancel, fourth row also cancel. And next, find the column penalties. First row was cancelled, as here we are having only one value, write that. And here also we are having only a single value, write that. So in this 11, 8 and 3, the maximum value is 11. So select that one. And now in this column, what is the value? 11. So to this one, let us assign the 15 number of units. So this will become 0 and here remaining are 15. So as second column is 0, so strike off that one. Now the one and only remaining value is 8. So to this one, I'll add the number of units of 15. So this one becomes 0 and this one becomes 0. Now see, all capacities became 0. Here also all demands became zeros. So now let us find the initial transportation cost. Initial transportation cost is equals to 11 into 15, 165, plus 8 into 15, 120, plus 12 into 25, 300, plus 7 into 35, 245, 12 into 40, 480. So find the total sum. So the sum is 1310. So this is the initial transportation cost. But he asked us to find the optimal solution. So we need to conduct the optimality test for this problem. Okay. So now let us conduct the optimality test. The optimality test, the method we are going to use is MODI method or UV method. Already you know about that. So here, first of all, I am taking the tabular column with 4 rows and 3 columns. So first write the basic cells. So basic cells means the cells which were allotted. So 11, 15, 8, 15, 12, 25, 7, 35, 12, 40. So these are known as basic cells. So now I am writing those cells. 11, 15, 8, 15, 12, 25, 7. 35, 12, 40. So in order to move to optimality test, we need to satisfy a condition, that is number of basic cells is equals to m plus n minus 1. So how many number of basic cells are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is equals to m means number of rows. How many rows are there? 4 rows are there. N means number of columns. How many columns are there? 3 minus 1. So 5 is not equals to 4 plus 3, 6 minus 4 plus 3, 7 minus 1, 6. So here it is 6 came. So 5 not equals to 6. So condition was not satisfied. So this situation we are calling it as degeneracy in transportation problem. We are calling it as degeneracy in transportation problem. That means number of basic cells are not equals to m plus n minus 1. So in this situation we are unable to find UV values also. If this condition was not satisfied, we cannot find the UV values. So in order to make these conditions satisfied, then we need to allot one more cell. So how to allot one more cell means, so now see the non-basic cells. So in the non-basic cells, what are the values are there? 21, 16, 20, 10, 18, 8, 9. So in all of these non-basic cells, what is the minimal value? 8. Now to this 8, we need to allot epsilon. So now I am allotting to this 8, I am allotting epsilon. Epsilon is nothing but 0. Epsilon means the value is nothing but 0. So there is no difference in the capacity and demand. If it is 0 means, so nothing will be happen. So the number of units will be same. But the in order to satisfy the condition, I am allotting with epsilon. So now again check. The number of basic cells are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And m plus n minus 1 value is also 6. So condition was satisfied. So now we can able to find UV values. U1, U2, U3, U4, V1, V2, V3. So now let us find the UV values. So U1, 0. Then V3 will become 8, V2 will become 11. As already you know how to find the UV values by the condition of UI plus VJ is equals to CIJ. So I already explained about this thing in the first video of MODI method. If anybody did not watch that, please watch that video. I am leaving that in the cards. So and next. If V3 is 8, then U2 is equals to 4. If V2 is 11, then U4 is equals to minus 3. If U4 is minus 3, V1 is 15. And then V2 is 11, then U3 is minus 4. So we found all UV values. Now let us write the non-basic cells. 21, 16, 20, 10, 18, 9. So let us find the penalties for the non-basic cells. So the penalty, how we are going to find the penalty? Penalty is equals to UI plus VJ minus CIJ. So by using that relation, we can be able to find the penalty. Now let us find the penalty. I am writing the penalty at the bottom left corner. 0 plus 15 minus 21 minus 6. Next to this cell we need to find 4 plus 15 minus 16. Then you will get 3. Next 4 plus 11 minus 20 minus 5. Next to this cell minus 4 plus 15 minus 10. Then you will get 1. Next to this cell, minus 4 plus 8 minus 18. Then you will get minus 14. Next to this cell, minus 3 plus 8 minus 9. Then you will get minus 4. Now let us check all the penalties, whether they are all of less than 0. So minus 6 less than 0, 3 positive value. Minus 5, 1, minus 14, minus 4. So two positive values we got, greater than 0, two values we got, so that we need to go for next iteration. Now we need to form a closed loop. So how to start the closed loop means, in the maximum positive penalties, where the maximum positive is there in the penalties, we need to start the loop. So here it is the maximum in 3 and 1, 3 is the maximum positive penalty. So my loop will start from here. So now I am going to form the loop. So if I go upward, as it is a non-basic cell, we can't change the direction. So if we go in this way, the loop will not form. Okay, so now I am moving in this direction. As it is a non-basic cell, so we need to continue the previous direction. So I am continuing the same direction. And again, it is a basic cell, so I can change the direction. So I am moving to this cell. Here it is again a basic cell. I can change the direction or I can continue. So if I continue, here it is a non-basic cell, we can't change the direction, so the loop will not form. So I am moving in upward direction. So again it is a basic cell. Here also I can move right, I can move up. If I move right, the closed loop will not form because it is a non-basic cell. So I am continuing the previous direction. Again it is a non-basic cell, so we need to continue the previous direction. Next, here it is a basic cell. I can move left or I can move right. If I move left means, here the loop will end. As it is a non-basic cell, I can't change the direction to down. So I am moving in right side direction. Again it is a basic cell, I can change the direction. Again it is a basic cell, I can change the direction. And again, as it is a non-basic cell, I can continue. So now the loop was closed. So what is the direction of the loop? So this one is the direction of the loop. So already I told you the loops may cross also. So here the loop was crossed. So like this also the loops may form. Okay. So now let us assign the positive and negatives alternatively, where the loop directions are changing. So here positive, and again loop direction is changing here, negative, and here again here loop direction is changing, positive, and again here loop direction is changing, negative, loop direction changing, positive, loop direction changing, negative, right? So and wherever we are, the loop is starting, we are going to allot there x number of units. We are going to allot x number of units. Now what is the value of x? So x is equals to minimum allocation value in the negative assignment cells. So what are the negative assignment cells? So minimum of, what are the negative assignment cells in allocation? Here negative assignment allocation is 40. Comma, again negative assignment cell, this one allocation is 15, and again here it is the negative allocation cell, allocation is 25. So in all these three, what is the minimal value? 15. Therefore x is equals to 15. Now let us go for next iteration with that. So I am going to next iteration. And again I am forming the table. With three columns and four rows. So this one is the table. Now, first of all, let us write the basic cells. So, what are the basic cells? Now, see this tabular column. So the x value is 15. So now add x value at positive assignments and add subtract x value at negative assignments. So first allocation cell, 15 minus 15. So 0 become, so it is non-basic cell. Next, 15 plus 15. So then it will become 30. So 8 and it is 30. Next, and here we need to add x units. So what is the value of x? 15. So 16, and here it will become 15. Next, basic cell, 25 minus 15. So here it will become 10. Next, here there is no any assignment, we are going to write that as it is. So 7, 35. Next, again, 40 minus 15, so 25, so 12, 25. Next, here, epsilon plus 15, so 8, epsilon plus 15. So, now all basic cells we have written. Now, again, check the condition. Number of basic cells is equals to m plus n minus 1. So how many number of basic cells are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is equals to number of rows 4, number of columns 3 minus 1. So 6 is equals to 6. Condition was satisfied. So now we can able to find the UV values. So let us find the UV values. U1, U2, U3, U4, and here V1, V2, V3. Already you know how to find the UV values. So I am arbitrarily considering 0 here. Then V3 become 8. If V3 is 8, U2 is 4. U2 is 4 means V1 is 12. V1 is 12 means U4 is 0. U4 is 0 means V2 is 8, then U3 will become minus 1. Then find the penalties for the non-basic cells. So first of all write the non-basic cells, 21 and then 11, next 20, 10, 18 and then 9. So now let us find the penalties for them. First penalty here, 0 plus 12 minus 21 minus 9. Next here, 0 plus 8 minus 11 minus 3. Next here, 4 plus 8 minus 20 minus 8. Next, minus 1 plus 12 minus 10. Then here you will get 1. Next here, minus 1 plus 8 minus 18. Then you will get minus 11. Next here, 0 plus 8 minus 9 minus 1. So now check the penalties whether all are negative. So here negative, negative. But here we got positive, negative, negative. So one positive value we got. So again, we need to go for next iteration by forming a closed loop. So my loop will start here. So in which direction I need to go? If I move upward, I can change the direction. So I can come to here and again I can't change the direction. And again I will come to here, I can change the direction up or down. If I move up, again the direction change, continue, continue. Here I can't change the direction, I can't move down. So the closed loop will not form. So going in upward is wrong. So I am moving in down, and again non-basic cell down. So I can't change the direction to left. So the loop will end here. Closed loop will not form. So moving in upward direction is not a possible case. So I am moving in right side direction. So again it is a basic cell. I can change the direction. Again it is a basic cell. I can change the direction. Again it is a basic cell. I can change the direction. So my closed loop is formed. So this is the direction of the loop. So here where the loop was started, I need to allot x units. Alternative assign positive and negatives where loop directions are changing. So positive, negative, positive, negative. So now let us find the value of x. So x is equals to minimum of negative assignments allocation. Here negative assignment allocation 35, and here negative assignment allocation 25. So minimum of 35 and 25 is 25. So x is equals to 25. So now again let us draw the table. So now I am going to draw the table again. With 3 columns and 4 rows. So first write the basic cells. So those are 8, 30, next 16, 15, next 12, 10, next. So up to the second row there are no any assignments, so that's why I have written them directly. Now from third row assignments are there. So here x 25 we need to add. So now I am adding that one to third. So 10, 25, next 35 minus 25, then it will become 10. Next, fourth row, 25 minus 25, it will become 0. Next, epsilon plus 15 plus 25, then it will become epsilon plus 40. Right? So now all basic cells were written. So now again check the condition. So what is the condition? Number of basic cells is equals to m plus n minus 1. So number of basic cells are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is equals to m. Number of rows are 4, number of columns are 3 minus 1. So that implies 6 is equals to 6. Condition was satisfied. Now find the UV values U1, U2, U3, U4. Then here V1, V2, V3. So arbitrarily take U1 is equals to 0. Then V3 will become 8. V3 is 8 means U2 is 4. U2 is 4 means V1 is 12. V1 is 12 means U3 is minus 2. U3 is minus 2 means V2 is 9. V2 is 9 means U4 is minus 1. So all UV values were we got. Then write the non-basic cells 21, 11, 20, 18, 12, 9. Now find the penalties for them. Finding UV values and penalties already explained in the previous problem. Please see that. If you did not watch that, I am leaving that in the cards. So now find the penalties. 0 plus 12 minus 21 minus 9. 0 plus 9 minus 11 minus 2, 4 plus 9 minus 20 minus 7, minus 2 plus 8 minus 18 minus 12, minus 1 plus 12 minus 12 minus 1, minus 1 plus 8 minus 9 minus 2. So now check the penalties, whether all are negative or not. Negative, 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 negative. So all penalties were negative values. So now we reach to the solution stage. So find the optimal transportation cost. So optimal transportation cost is equals to 8 into 30, 240, 16 into 15, 240, 12 into 10, 120, 10 into 25, 250, 7 into 10, 70, plus, here I already told epsilon means 0, so 40 plus 0 means 40 will get, so 40 into 8, 320, so that equals 2. So find the total sum of this, it is 1240. So optimal transportation cost is 1240 rupees. Let us check whether it is less than the initial cost or not. So the initial transportation cost is 1310 rupees, but the optimal transportation cost is 1240. So we got a lesser of 70 rupees. So it is correct value we got. So like this, we need to solve the transportation problem when there is a arise of situation degeneracy. So I think already you understand what is degeneracy. If this condition was not satisfied, then we will call it as degeneracy in transportation problem. In that situation, we are going to add a value of epsilon. So like this, we need to solve the problems. So I hope you understand this one. So if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe. Okay, so thank you all of you for your patience listening.